Welcome to the PlayStation Store Summer Sale Part 2. Let's see what games to get this time. Battlefield 5 is a first-person shooter that has 4 out of 10 in 30 hours, and it's definitely a breeze-through, especially since the previous Battlefield games takes a lot of time and effort to complete. This might be the easiest one to date since there's no DLC trophies to even worry about. Fun fact, I never really liked Final Fantasy 8 during the first PlayStation days. Now I can go back to why I hated it, but that's not the point. It's a 3 out of 10, 50 hours. It looks a little quicker to complete than Final Fantasy 9, so here's another RPG to eventually play whenever I get a chance. Final Fantasy 9, originally on the first PlayStation, is now re-released on the PS4. One of the Final Fantasy games I have never played and will finally get a chance when possible, but it's a 8 out of 10, 75 hours for an RPG game. It will definitely take a while to complete. American Fugitive is a possible classic GTA 1 and 2 feel that has a 4 out of 10 in 16 hours, and it's stackable, but I recommend completing it first to see if it's even worth playing it again. There's a lot of stuff to do in the game, but it really varies on gameplay. Yeah, I don't know how to pronounce this, but it basically is a VR-only point-and-click game, and you probably need 2 move controllers to complete this game, as it has a 2 out of 10 and maybe 4 hours if you use a guide. Well, it's a From Software game since they made Dark Souls, so consider this an easy From Software game to complete. White Day is a survival horror game that was out in probably 2001 before, so now it's a decade later and it's on PS4 now, and it may take a while to complete as the game is a 6 out of 10 in 60 hours, and you have to play it multiple times if you want to, but just play it once to see if you like it or not before you decide to stack the hell out of this game. Monster of the Deep is another VR only game with also 2 move controllers where you fish and use crossbows, and that's basically all I know. Other than that, I need to play Final Fantasy 15 before playing this, but it does have a 3 out of 10 and 30 hours to complete, and you can basically play it 5 times if you want to complete it 5 times, so I hope it's good enough to play this multiple times. Steins Gate Zero is a visual novel notorious for its ultimate stacks and sequels, which also stacks too. The thing is, now I can actually read on what's going on in the game instead of just playing the Japanese version and skipping everything to the platinum. But if you do decide to skip everything, this will usually take 2 hours to complete, as the difficulty is kind of a maybe a 2 out of 10 if there's a guide on the directions to the platinum. And that's 8 games to buy this week. Let me know in the comments section which game to play, and I'll see you on part 3.